Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making a refreshing spa cooler. And I wanted to show you that our daylilies are in full bloom. And before they stop blooming, I wanted to have a bouquet in here in the kitchen. So it's going to be sitting over here as I prepare our spa cooler. Now that's just a drink. And it's a water drink. It's water that will have a little bit of flavor to it, but the main thing is that it's so attractive. It's cooling just to look at it. Now, if you've been here in Kentucky, you know that we've been having a heat wave for the last week or so. Temperatures have been in the 90s Fahrenheit, and it's just been very muggy outside, and it would be nice to have a cool, refreshing drink. So I decided to dress up water, and I think you'll enjoy it. So let's look at some of the things that I have setting out here. I've got some water, and I just took this from the tap. You might want to use bottled water if that's what you always drink. Now, what we're going to put into the water depends on what you like, but I've got some choices here that will make it nice and refreshing. Citrus is always good, and you want to pick things that will not fall apart on you. So here I've taken a lime, and you want slices that are almost paper thin, but you don't want them to be in shapes other than circles. So you can get a little too thin on them if you start shaving them down. So I've got a few there to work with. Here is an orange. And this is a seedless orange, fortunately. Otherwise, I would have had to dig out the seeds. But again, you want thin slices. This is a lemon, same thing. It does have seeds, so as I went through these, I have removed all the seeds. Now back here, I have a zucchini, which I plan to use for a different recipe, but I thought I could just take a little bit off the end and no one would ever know of the other recipe that it was missing three slices. So I'm gonna have double usage here. I cut off the end, and then you just want to make your slices not too thick, not too thin, but you're picking things that will not fray on you in the water. They will not dissolve. They will not turn the water some color that is undesirable. Along the lines of the zucchini, I have cucumber. I first took a few pieces off the end, and that was so I would be able to garnish this drink a little bit. So if I choose to use those, I will have them. But then I used a parer. And just going lengthwise, I got some nice slices like that that will be dropped into the water. And it's really nice if you get to the seeded part where you can see the actual texture of the cucumber. Otherwise, you have something like that, which isn't quite as pretty, but it's usable. And nothing looks cooler than a cucumber in water. So I think you'll really enjoy seeing a slice of cucumber and the zucchini. It's not going to be all fruit. It's going to have some vegetables. It's going to have some herbs as well. The next vegetable I have is a carrot, and I took care of this last night. These are carrot curls. I have a quick tip on how to make them if you want to look that quick tip up. Did that a couple years ago, I think. But you just roll them up after you have used a parer to slice them from a peeled carrot. And then you put a toothpick all the way through and then put them into water. You can see the water is kind of orange. You put ice cubes in it, and overnight the ice cubes will melt. There's a little bit of ice right there. But you'll basically have a curl that if you want to uncurl it a little bit, you may, and you can twist it a little bit, lengthen it, whatever you want to do with those. But that is a good idea to add those for color and for texture and for just the unusual look. Now I have berries. We have raspberries, we have blackberries, and we have blueberries. These have all been washed. Everything here has been cleaned. So don't worry about that, and you need to do that if you're going to make this. I picked berries that will not fall apart. If you have strawberries and you slice them, then more than likely they're going to just start dissolving, and that's going to taint your water, give it a color that you don't want, seeds are going to fall out, and it's just not a really good choice. But if you really like it, go ahead and use it. Back here, I don't think I mentioned that I have ginger. And that will just add a little bit of delicate flavor. And I have a couple of pieces of ginger. I've used some already this morning. But just take your knife and slice off as many pieces there, like this, as you feel like you want to put into your spa cooler. And now we have our herbs. I didn't know what I would want to do with these in particular, so I got some mint from our herb garden. That, remember, it's in a pot separate from the herb garden. And then I got some of the curly parsley. And everything is growing really well, even though it's been hot and there hasn't been any rain probably for a week. One thing about herbs, at least here in Kentucky, is that they grow well under poor conditions. So the soil doesn't have to be great and the watering doesn't have to be perfect. Otherwise, Rick and I wouldn't have any herbs because we did hardly anything last year after planting them, and we don't like to put artificial items on there if we can help it. But I have some cilantro here and the curly parsley. I decided not to do the flat parsley, and there were other herbs I could have chosen, but I thought these were most likely to look good and taste good in water. So here is some water that I have, and I'm just going to start picking some things and placing them in here. A slice of orange, maybe. You want some that will float to the top, and then let's do one of these cucumber pieces, which will wrap around probably a little bit. And you can arrange these if you want. Some will sink to the bottom, like the ginger goes down to the bottom. Here's the zucchini. It's pretty hip. Well, I don't know. The inside is kind of light. It's going to float. Berries, like blueberries, probably will go to the bottom. And you have total control over this, so whatever looks good to you, you can put in there. So I'm going to be working on this and arranging and designing it for you, and I will come back and serve up some of our nice, refreshing spa cooler. You can see how nice and refreshing our spa cooler looks. It even looks cool when you look at it. So I want you to know that I did not use a lot of the stuff that I had out here to show you. I was just showing you, you can use this and this and this, but you could make a lot of the spa cooler from the materials that I have here. Actually, I bought my fruit to make a fruit salad, and you'll be seeing a fruit salad before too long that has some very familiar looking fruit in it. But to finish this up, I want to tell you that it is served over ice. So you just pour it out, and whatever goes out with it, that will be fine. I have two that are prepared here, and I'll take a sip of one in just a second. But if you want to put your ice in the pitcher, then you can just drop it in and it will sort of cling to the top, and it will cause some of the additions to move aside a little bit. But you can have the ice actually in there, or you can put it in the refrigerator, let it cool down, and then pour it over ice like this. Nevertheless, you'll come out with something like this, and I'll just take a drink of this for you, and I think it's going to taste mainly like water. But there is something about the illusion of it being cool that makes it refreshing. And if you let it sit for a while in the refrigerator, the water will absorb some of those flavors. It will be very subtle, but I think you'll enjoy it. Let's try it. Actually, the herb, which I don't know what to put in there, I think it was cilantro, was very tasty. Maybe it's because I was right on that spot. I'll move around a little bit. Maybe it'll taste like orange now. It definitely is flavored water. You would not mistake this for just regular water. I think you'll enjoy this treat because it's the kind of thing you might want to have for brunch. You might want to have it for a light lunch, particularly some of you ladies that get together for little fancy sandwiches and so on. This is wonderful. Or if you're sitting by the pool, or if you have that luxury, then if you can manage to have this cold inside the building, then bring it out and have some. It's going to look delicious and it's going to cool you off really fast. I hope you enjoy it.